welcome to another edition of Currently in Quincy. I'm Joe Catalano. On today's program, we chat with Rick Doane from Interfaith Social Services and learn all about their Stop the Stigma road race that's coming up later on this month. First, though, we'll check out the weather and the news for you this morning. Currently in Quincy, kind of gray and damp out there. It's 47 degrees. Right now, mostly cloudy today with highs into the mid-50s this afternoon. We've got rain on the way, but not till later tonight, probably after sunset. And this evening's lows, not as cold as it has been, only around 50 degrees. The showers will linger into tomorrow morning, but once the sun comes out tomorrow, it's going to warm up 70 degrees, maybe even milder by tomorrow afternoon. Not too bad on Sunday. The clouds are moving in again with high Sunday into the mid-60s, but Marathon Monday looks rather wet. Cold and raw and damp. It'll warm up later in the day on Monday for Patriots Day, but the start of the race and all of the Patriots Day activities out in Lexington and Concord have been kind of damp on Monday morning with temperatures really only around 60 degrees by later in the day, but it'll start out rather cool and raw. Right now, 47 with clouds here in Quincy. In the news today, the Quincy City Council is right in the middle of debating the latest plan to continue the redevelopment of Quincy Center. Councilors this week did begin reviewing Mayor Thomas Koch's proposal to transfer a portion of the former Ross Parking Garage location over to Fox Rock Properties for development of an outpatient medical complex, a 140-room hotel, and a 110-unit apartment complex. Ward 4 City Councilor Brian Palmucci says he'd like some personal reassurances from Fox Rock Properties President Rob Hale about the development plan.
And I'm not saying that they aren't a good company and that we shouldn't work with them, we shouldn't use them as a partner. Maybe at some point we'll get to a place through this process where they are a good working partner. But that level of trust, when I said I don't trust Fox Rock, is I don't trust them right now. Maybe I will, maybe I won't. Maybe the numbers won't add up to me, or maybe we won't get numbers. But I am not personally at a place where I trust Fox Rock now, at a place where I have been in the past with the level of trust that's exist with Peter O'Connell, who has a body of work in the city of Quincy, and who also provided numbers. By the end of the process, we had those numbers, and you know, the council supported it. Same with, you know, the Galvins, who I know we haven't done LDAs with them, but they're building downtown. LBC, we've done an LDA with them. They're executing. We haven't done that. There isn't the same level of trust for me anyways with Fox Rock.
Other parts of the plan include borrowing $61 million to make some pretty major underground utility and roadway improvements and expand the area where the city could take downtown property by eminent domain for future developments. Boston officials continue to push for the construction of a new Long Island bridge and then open up a substance abuse treatment center on Long Island. Quincy officials continue to oppose the bridge proposal, saying it will create dangerous traffic through Squantum and North Quincy. During a community meeting in Boston earlier this week, people impacted by the opioid abuse epidemic pleaded for the treatment center, saying it is vital to the people struggling with substance abuse. Quincy officials say they support the treatment center, but they want Boston to develop a ferry service to the island rather than rebuilding the bridge. Quincy also says Boston has designated Long Island an economic opportunity zone that would pave the way for future development there. The former bridge was demolished 4 years ago due to some structural concerns. Quincy man has been charged with running a major drug distribution operation out of his apartments. 35-year-old Robert Cooley, charged with selling cocaine, marijuana, methamphetamine, and THC cartridges from his apartment at 6 Quarry Street. Police seized drugs worth at least $325,000, along with $30,000 in cash, a loaded handgun, ammunition, and some other drug paraphernalia after executing a search warrant back on Monday night. 35-year-old Jeffrey Wilson from Roxbury was also arrested. Police say he purchased drugs from Cooley at the apartment. Cooley is being held on $100,000 bail. Wilson was ordered held on $500 bail. Brewster Ambulance Service recently made a $500 donation to the Quincy Police Department's DARE Drug Abuse Resistance Education Program. George Brewster Jr. and Mark Brewster brought a symbolic check to police headquarters earlier this week. They were joined by Quincy Police Chief Paul Keenan, Officers Don Sauter, Melanie Reeves, along with Chris DeBona, Mark Gessareo, and Scott Bowles. Officer Sauter and Reeves are the DARE officers in the Quincy Public Schools. But now that you are up to date with weather and news, let's check out our programming lineup for you for later on today here on Quincy Access Television. I'll start with the replay of this program currently in Quincy today at 5 o'clock. After that, at 6, join us for Sound Advice with Attorney Tom Williams.
Hello, folks. I'm Attorney Tom Williams, and welcome to Sound Advice.
6:30 a.m. Quincy, we feature tomorrow's South Shore Science Festival. Then at 7 o'clock a.m. Quincy welcomes Quincy Ward 6 Counselor William Harris. Right, Quincy Recreation Department's Middle School Basketball Championship tonight at 7:30 on Channel 8. After that at 8:30, it's the Rec Department's George Dunn High School Basketball Championship.
And we have our stat guy, Pat.
Studio Sessions, Episode 1, tonight at 9:30. And at 10 o'clock, the Norfolk County Prevention Coalition program topic tonight, Making Good Decisions. Check out Channel 9 every day. Learn about Quincy City Department's different committee activities. Starts at 5:30 with Quincy in Focus. Six o'clock, Update DPW, all about the spring season. Brand new FYI from the Quincy Health Department at 6:30, tonight's topic, macular degeneration. 7 o'clock, In the Know, details about the Senior Circuit Breaker tax credits. An update on this week's Board of License Commissioners meeting on AM Quincy at 7:30. Then AM Quincy at 7:45, we feature the Thomas Crane Public Library Foundation fundraiser. 8 o'clock, we go at the Kennedy Center and hear from their guest speaker, Ray Flynn. Meet the Artists, episode number 2, tonight at 9 on Channel 9. Then at 9:30, find out what is happening at your library for the month of April.
Hello.
Get a complete program schedule over on our website. Go to qatv.org and click on Program Schedule. Also, you can always like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter. Don't forget to see our weekly ad in the Quincy Sun. Coming up, we'll take a look at a few of the current events and activities featured now in our electronic bulletin board on Channel 8 for your information. Stay tuned, please. We're back with you in 1 minute. Back. Here is a check of some of the current events and activities we're showing in our electronic bulletin board on Channel 8 for your information. There's a bake sale coming up at O'Brien Towers on Bicknell Street in Germantown on April 18th at noontime. It's a fundraiser for the Tenants Association. Vendors are welcome. Just call Grace at 617-471-0738. Information sessions about the new Quincy College nursing program will be held on April 19th at the Quincy Center campus and April 27th at the Plymouth campus. You should visit quincycollege.edu for all the details. The annual Mayor's Prayer Breakfast is scheduled for Thursday, May 2nd at the Terrell Room on Quarry Street here in Quincy. The event will include a full breakfast, speakers, music, and prayers from select Quincy houses of worship. You can visit interfaithsocialservices.org for tickets and for more information. And a fundraiser to benefit the St. Eve's School in Haiti is scheduled for May 19th from 6 to 9 at the Knights of Columbus Hall on Hancock Street in North Quincy. The music raffles and an auction, all part of the event this year, and tickets will be available right at the door. And if you have an event or an activity you'd like to promote, visit our website, qatv.org. When you get there, just download a bulletin board request form, fill it out, and send it in. We'll put your message up here on Channel 8, too. Coming up, we chat with Rick Doane of Interfaith Social Services about their upcoming Stop the Stigma 5K. That's next. Well, welcome back. We're so pleased to welcome back to the program Rick Doane from Interfaith Social Services, because it's time, believe it or not, another sign of spring here in Quincy, the Stop the Stigma 5K Road Race. It's coming up on April 27th. That's a Saturday at the Kennedy Center. Always a huge event, Rick.
Yeah, getting bigger every year.
Yeah.
Thankfully, this is our 45th.
45th.
Yeah.
But it hasn't always been called Stop the Stigma, right?
It was called the South Shore Walk for many years. And it moved around, but it's been here in Quincy for at least the last 25 years.
Wow.
It used to move around to different communities in the South Shore. And it really was to support our services. But a couple of years ago, we saw the opiate epidemic. We saw so many families that were struggling with mental illness that we said, we need to do something to raise awareness about this issue. And we rebranded it as Stop the Stigma 5K.
Yeah, remove the stigma from the issue of mental health, right?
That's right.
Yeah.
And, unfortunately, there's still too many people that view mental illness and addiction as a character flaw.
Mm.
They say, oh, well, suck it up. Just do better.
Mm-hmm.
Overcome
mm-hmm.
it.
Yeah.
And it doesn't work that way.
Right.
You wouldn't say that to somebody with a broken arm. You know, deal with it.
Yeah.
And so we're trying to break down those barriers. And this gives us an opportunity to be on programs like this, talking about it.
To say this, right?
Yeah, that's the whole point we're doing this event.
Is it working, do you think?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I mean, at least the event, we looked at it. We've been doing it for so long. We wanted to raise awareness. Each year since we changed the focus, it has got bigger and bigger and bigger. This year, last year we had under 400 participants. This year we're expecting over 500 participants.
Wow, that's a huge jump in 1 year.
Yeah, we already, there's hundreds of more people that are registering. We know that more people will come out the day of the event.
Right.
A lot of people wait for the weather forecast.
Yes.
But we have people who, their loved ones have mental illness. These are people who are clients of our counseling center. These are therapists from other counseling centers.
Mm.
Grieving families that have lost loved ones to the opiate epidemic.
Yep.
And they're walking together as teams to in memory of their loved ones.
Okay, that's fantastic, because that's what it's all about. And you've made it more than just come, walk, and leave, right? It's a big event.
It is. Yeah. Well, because we want that's not enough. Coming out, walking, and then leaving.
Mm-hmm.
We want to get people together. We want people talking about this issue. We want people to overcome that stigma. You have events like cancer walks and all these other events, and there's no stigma related to them. And so the same thing with this, people should be able to talk openly about their illnesses. And so we hope families will come together, and we saw it happen last year.
That's great.
We saw a family that came out for our event. The mother hadn't told her children about her mental illness, her young children.
Really?
And after this event, she chose to share with them.
Wow.
So and
coming
it's great.
Out of sorts.
It really is. Yeah.
Well, we see physical disabilities embraced. We see it in the Boston Marathon, certainly with folks using prosthetics and the wheelchair category now. And it's heralded. It's celebrated. Look what these folks can do.
It's visual.
It's visual, right.
And it is amazing that people can do that. It is amazing. But there are people who are suffering.
Yes.
And it's not visible.
Right.
And so hopefully this is bringing awareness to them.
Yeah, so this particular event is for your New Directions Counseling Center, right?
Yeah, that's right. And so our counseling center is actually our oldest program.
Yeah, that's how it started.
All of our other programs.
Protestant Social Services.
That's
Bureau, right.
Even before that, it was Protestant Community Services.
Oh, I don't remember that one. Okay.
And then Protestant Social Service Bureau. Yeah, that was back in when it was originally founded.
Okay.
But our counseling center, it's really a safety net for the community.
Yep.
Making sure people that need emergency assistance around mental health have those resources. Many of our people are suffering, and they have such high deductibles.
Yep.
they can't afford to get help, and sure. this is an opportunity somewhere where they can get help. Also, people who do have health insurance. And it's a place in the community where they can come and get help.
Well, no, interestingly, I just had the president of Bethesda Deaconess Milton Hospital on the program.
I saw that on their Facebook page.
Okay. and he mentioned specifically they're adding behavioral health to their emergency department. I mean, really as a frontline defense to try and get it diagnosed and treated immediately.
Well, I mean, so many people go there.
Right.
And you do not treat mental illness mm-hmm. the way you treat most other injuries.
Right.
I got a call from a mom yesterday. She called me. This is a personal friend. She said, my daughter, she's 15 years old. She's in the emergency room. She's had, a psychotic break.
Yeah.
And what's this going to look like? What's going to happen? And I said, well, luckily we've come further along than we have in the past.
Right.
But still, we want to prevent people from getting to the emergency room.
Right.
We want to get them the treatment so they don't have to do that. Because that's not the ideal place to treat these things.
Yeah, well, I mean, there was a budget shift years ago, probably, gosh, almost 20 years ago now, away from specific institutions, if you will,
yeah.
dealing with mental illness. But the problem, the people didn't go away. That's still there.
Well, and those were long-term
right.
diagnoses. These are people really, and actually, we have some of our counseling clients came out of that.
Is that right?
Setting. Okay. And, they're still sort of suffering because of the setting
yeah.
in addition to their diagnosis.
Yeah. So do you think the goal, as it is with, physical ailments, with mental ailments, to keep people in their homes and have them treated on kind of an outpatient basis?
That's the way it should be.
Yeah.
Treat it before it becomes a crisis.
Yeah.
So they don't have to go to the emergency room.
Right.
That's what we're hoping people will do. When they hear this, that they'll reach out for help. When they see that there isn't a stigma, and they'll say, I'm going to get the help I need.
So let's talk about the day, if we can, a little bit, Rick.
Yeah.
It's, again, Saturday, April 27th at the Kennedy Center, where it's been pretty much since it started, right?
Wow, it's beautiful.
Yeah, it's a gorgeous setting, for sure.
It is.
Yeah. It's a 5K, so a little over 3 miles.
Yep.
What happens that day?
Well, people show up. They register now.
Okay.
So our T-shirt deadline is today.
Okay. All right.
but anybody can still register afterwards. We just won't have T-shirts for them. Register for the event. They can come that morning, check in.
Oh, what time?
We have 8:30.
Okay.
Our check-in starts. The race starts at 9:30.
Okay.
Earlier the better. You get there. And then we're going to have bagels and ice cream and lots of fun stuff.
And bagels and ice cream.
Well, bagels before.
Okay.
Ice cream. New England Ice Cream is one of our sponsors.
Okay. Very nice.
And people who participate in this event every year, they get back from the 5K, and they feel like they earned that ice cream.
Okay.
And so we have ice cream waiting for them from New England
All right.
Ice Cream.
Okay.
But we have some amazing sponsors, Arbel Insurance, Boston Medical Center Health Net Plan. We have Heritage is one of our sponsors this year. They are amazing partners. But there's bouncy houses.
Okay.
There's airbrush tattoos.
Wow.
There's events for kids. There's raffles. There's games where people can win prizes. It's fun.
Mm.
That's what this is about.
And is it a race? Is it an actual race or is it just one?
Oh, it's timed.
It's timed.
Yeah, okay. We have more than half the participants are runners.
Okay.
And we have a professional company that times it. We have awards for the top three men, top three women in different age categories.
Okay.
Yeah.
About how long does it take, the whole event?
Well, a fast runner is about 25 minutes.
Okay.
But walkers, it's 45 minutes or so.
Okay.
And it's beautiful. You go up and around Squantum,
yep.
See the views of the skyline, come back, have a little bit of relaxed time, and then head off to sports in the afternoon, because that's
right.
what I'll be doing. My kids got baseball that afternoon.
Sure.
Yeah.
And the T-shirts, as you mentioned, can you buy them even if it's deadline to?
Well, no. I mean, we have to pre-order them and pre-print them.
Okay.
And for so many years, we tried to guess how many people were going to be there, and then we'd have T-shirts left over, and so that's why we started doing this deadline.
Okay. And it says right on them, "Stop the Stigma."
So we want
you're
people to
put it out loud and proud. Yeah.
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 Big on the shirt, "Stop the Stigma."
Yep.
So we hope people will stop somebody and say, what does that mean?
What's the stigma?
What's the stigma?
Yeah.
So that it can get people talking.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know what I did want to ask you before we run out of time is you're very well aware that the Esther Sanger Center for Compassion is closing after like 40 years or so. I know that you at Interfaith are going to try and serve those people that
we're working. It's a team of us.
Okay.
So it's us, Salvation Army, Weymouth Food Pantry.
Oh, okay.
We're helping to try to coordinate that because we know after April 30th,
right.
The Sanger Center won't be here anymore. And so we're trying to make sure we're working on getting communication out to all the clients.
Okay.
We're working on talking with the volunteers, trying to transition their current volunteers into other programs. Salvation Army has stepped up. Hopefully they're going to be able to start doing some deliveries.
Great.
And we've already seen some clients that had been served that are starting to come to our food pantry.
Right. They had a different model. They were more of a delivery service that
right.
people would come to them as opposed to Interfaith where you have folks come to the pantry.
And they were another resource
yes,
too.
Yeah.
You know, it was somewhere where people who needed help more than once a month could go.
Right.
But what we're seeing right now, we're trying to figure out of all those clients, you know, who are the ones that really can't get out of their houses
yes.
and need these services,
yep.
and then reach out to each of them on an individual basis.
Yeah, I couldn't help but think, gosh, you know, Interfaith seems to be thriving after 70 years and so successful in serving its mission. And the Crisis Center struggled, you know, throughout those years. It was a different setting.
You know, things have changed.
Yeah.
We have corporate partners that had given us money for years.
Yep.
We've seen a shift for foundations away from emergency assistance.
Really?
Focusing more on jobs creation, focusing more on measurable outcomes.
Okay.
And when we're just providing food, we're not going to be able to show those lifelong outcome changes when we're just trying to feed somebody.
Yes. Yeah.
So we've seen it. We've been hit hard over the years with people that had been giving to us, and they were similar funders.
Okay.
So yeah, we feel for everybody and the legacy that Esther Sanger left. And we're keeping that phone number alive.
Are you really?
Okay. So that phone number that Esther Sanger gave out throughout Quincy
yes.
that has gone to the Quincy Crisis for years,
yep.
we are going to keep that phone number alive so that anybody who calls it can still get help.
That is amazing.
Yeah, so we're working with them to try to figure out those logistics.
Yeah, she would love that. I knew Esther for a short time, and she would love that. She was very strong-willed. She was a nurse, actually as a profession, but also really cared deeply about people and the community. So that would make her happy, I'm sure.
Well, it's a team effort.
Yeah.
You know, it's a community, and everybody from QCAP's Food Pantry and Salvation Army and Germantown, and we have a great community here in Quincy, and everybody's rallying to meet this need.
Great.
It's a really wonderful place to live and work.
And another way to show that support, again, is the Stop the Stigma 5K.
That's right.
Again, Saturday, April 27th at the Kennedy Center. And will you know kind of that day, Rick, how the event?
Yeah.
You will, okay.
We will.
Yeah.
But people should register, interfaithsocialservices.org.
Okay.
Pre-register so that we know how many people are going to show up.
Obviously, yeah.
Yeah.
I'm not even going to ask if there's an inclement weather date. It's
no.
No.
We have
okay.
rain or shine, we're going to be there.
Okay. All right.
With bagels and ice cream.
And maybe ponchos, who knows?
And New England Revolution. Pat the Patriot is going to be there.
Oh, no kidding. Okay.
He's coming. We have some really fun surprises planned.
Okay.
So, yeah, it's going to be a fun day.
All right. Sounds like fun. Thanks a lot for coming over, and I hope you have another great event this year.
Thank you.
You are welcome. Another quick break. Back with more on the program in just a moment. Back. Just enough time to recap the weather forecast for you for the rest of the day today. Kind of what you see is what you get out there. It's overcast. It's gray. It's rather raw. Temperatures will top off in the mid-50s this afternoon, and it won't be as cold tonight as it has been, down around 50 degrees. The rain is going to move in late tonight and last through tomorrow morning, but the sun will come out later, warm us up to the low 70s tomorrow. Not too bad on Sunday. Lots of clouds around mid-60s, and we're getting wet again with April showers here on Marathon Monday. It'll be warmer than it was predicted. Highs Monday around 60 degrees. Thanks again going out to Rick Doane from Interfaith Social Services for joining us today. Thank you to our crew. Thank you for watching. We're off on Monday for the Patriots Day holiday. Back next Friday with Al Bina from the Quincy Quarry and Granite Workers Museum on another live edition of Currently in Quincy. We'll see you then.